Hi, I'm Nikki Simone.
It's amazing to have you here tonight. Can you tell us about your film, The Host? Because obviously there's a lot of excitement in that and a lot of the cast here tonight. Can you tell us what the film's generally about and where you fit into it?
So the film's basically, it's a thriller. It's a Hitchcockian thriller, and it's really great. It's probably a slow burn film, but as you get into it, it's really the twists and the turns. And there is one shocker in the film, which I'm not going to give away, but... yeah, everyone's pretty shocked at that one scene. So, you know, you have to... it's probably my favourite scene in the movie, but I'm not going to give anything more away about that. I play Patricia, and she basically holds a lot of the secrets, basically, in the movie. So she kind of... she's an interesting character. Trying to think the best way to describe her in the third person. She's basically the person who everyone kind of keeps. She keeps everyone's secrets. That's basically all I can really say about the character without giving too much away on the movie, to be honest with you.
We don't want you to spoil anything. But you do seem to be spoiled with an amazing cast around about. You can talk about the rest of the team working on this and what it was like working with them.
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, like, Mike Beckingham was on the movie, so he's been fantastic to work with. And then, obviously, Dougie. He's been an absolute gem working alongside him. And then I was in the scene with Dominic Keating, and you know, he's obviously quite a legend up there with all the sci-fi fans, and so you know, it was amazing working with such a fantastic actor. Everyone's working with the rest of the cast has been a really amazing experience, and they feel like part of my family, to be honest with you, at the end of this.
How does it feel to be here tonight at the Critics Circle Awards in the heart of London? A fantastic celebration of cinema ahead of us tonight.
Oh, absolutely. It feels amazing to be here tonight. Very lucky to be here tonight. And I think you're going to see some amazing talents walk through the door as well. So it's going to be a good evening. I have a good feeling about it.
But I'm here for the first time, checking it out, and it's really quite nice. Looking forward to it.
Can you tell us a little bit about the story of The Host and what it was that excited you about being part of the project?
Well, I read the script about 2 years ago. I read the script and I had a little piece in the film. And unfortunately, time was not on their side, so it had to go. But I was commissioned to write the song for the film, which we did in kind of 3-4 hours. And really quite, Zach did test my ability. And I have to say, I'm so glad he did, because you can pull out of the bag something you never thought you had. So we wrote the song, got on the film set, got my hair done and what have you, ready in no time, and we filmed it. And then the next day went into the studio, recorded the soundtrack, and it was great. Yeah, came out all right.
Of course, I mean, you've been blessed to work with some of the biggest icons in music over the years. Did you draw on any of those particular inspirations for this track, for this work?
You know what? I've been in the industry for about 35 years. What you do is you draw on the experience of your work. You know, I've been on it for a long time. And more importantly, you know, I am a songwriter, really, as well, should I say, dare I say it. And so I just got on with it, really. But, you know, I love music. I'm a fan. And, you know, given the opportunity to write the track, I couldn't say no and I couldn't back down, so I went for it.
It's amazing to have you here with us at the Critics Circle Awards. Obviously, you've got a very exciting film coming out very imminently with The Host. Can you tell us a little bit about that one? Why should we be getting excited?
Yeah, sure. It's kind of like a modern-day Hitchcock thriller with a lot of horror thrown in. And we've kind of turned it on its head a little bit in terms of what Hitchcock did with the legendary film Psycho, and yeah, we just kind of wanted to pay homage to it a little bit, you know, and we went out to Amsterdam for 5 weeks to shoot in some amazing locations. We really became kind of part of a family, and we kind of hope that the audiences will watch it and get taken on this journey with my character Robert, who makes some interesting decisions, makes some interesting life decisions, and what the point is, I think, is that depending if you make a decision or not, it doesn't make you a good or bad person. You can learn from it. So, yeah, it's due out now. It's on Amazon Prime. So Robert, for me, I wanted to make him the kind of humanizing, if that's a word, I don't know, the kind of humanizing element of the story. So, like I said, we've all gone through life and made a decision, and it's not necessarily defined us, but we've certainly learned a lot of things from it. And so we pick up the story from Robert, and he makes some interesting decisions, interesting choices. It leads it down a very, very deep rabbit hole, and hopefully you'll go on that journey with him.
A lot of the great projects you've been involved with have that kind of horror, that psychological dimension to it. What is it about that as a storyteller and an audience that is so compelling?
Well, I got years ago when I was doing a horror movie, I got told that when you watch a horror movie, it has the same chemical reaction in your body as love. So you kind of want to keep doing it, you know? You kind of have that sensation. So I think that's it. I think it's science. So I just finished on a TV show with Simon Pegg and Nick Frost called Truth Seekers, which is due out this year. And I'm due to start a movie with Billy Zane called Waltzing with Brando in April of this year. We go to Fiji to start shooting that in April, May time. So I'm very excited.
We're excited about that as well. That's a great pairing, you and Billy. Can you tell us anything more about that one, where you fit into that?
Yeah, absolutely. So Billy is going to be playing Marlon Brando, which is the first depiction of Marlon Brando ever to be done. And I don't think there's a better actor out there that looks and feels and suits Marlon Brando than Billy Zane. I'm going to play a character called Bernard Judge, which the story evolves around. He's an LA architect who became very pioneering because he created the first spherical home in the LA Hills. And basically, it's got a very wonderful story short. Bernard wants to build a self-sustaining property on an island. Brando's got the island and the money, so these two worlds collide in a wonderful way. It's a real feel-good story. And you're going to see a very different side to Brando in this.
Hi, everyone. I'm Zachary Weckstein, the headline sponsor of this year for Pro Pictures Productions.
This particular celebration of cinema, such a special and important night, do you think?
I think it's wonderful because we're here celebrating some wonderful artists, wonderful filmmakers, people who've worked so hard, and their teams as well, who've worked so hard, their producers, their directors, the writers, makeup departments, and coming here to celebrate the wonderful craftsmanship of their talents.
Talking about great talents, I know that there's a particular film, The Host, that you guys are releasing to us very imminently, both in the States and over here. Can you tell us a little bit about what we can expect from that very special production?
Well, you should be expecting some thrill, some suspense, but some also ease in your brain that you won't be actually leaving the cinema with nightmares at the end of the evening, but that it can still leave you with some suspense and not knowing exactly what the actual tale will bring. So not always knowing what element will happen next, which I think is really important in storytelling.
We've heard the film described as very much a sort of a modern Hitchcock. What is it about that genre that keeps audiences, whatever generation, coming back for more again and again?
I think it's a thrill. I think it's the onion layer suspense, you know, peeling, you know, layers that Hitchcock created, as well as all these wonderful other talents have created along the years. And for me, I'm just so grateful and happy that I get to be a part of that, time classic period, you know, thriller genre piece.
And apart from that, is there anything else you've got coming up at the moment that you're especially excited about, that you're involved with, that you want to share with us?
Well, I'm just trying to focus mostly on the PR and the marketing and the distribution of worldwide sales of cinemas and everything else, but also have my hands and toes in a few things which will be coming up in the next coming years. So a little different kind of genre, more action-based, but very excited about all the things to come.